burns. Burns, damage to the skin or deeper tissues caused by sun, hot liquids, fire, electricity or chemicals. Burns can be minor medical problem or life-threatening emergencies. Classification of burns. Burns are classified according to the depth of tissue destruction. First degree burns, second degree burns and third degree burns. Causes of burn injuries. Burns are caused by fire, hot liquid or steam, hot metal, glass or other objects, electrical current, radiation, sunlight or other sources of ultraviolet radiation, chemicals such as strong acids. First degree burns definition. This minor burn affects only the outer layer of the skin, means epidermis. It may cause redness and pain. Second degree burn affects both the epidermis and the second layer of the skin, means dermis. It may cause swelling and red or white skin. Blisters may develop and pain can be severe. Deep second degree burns can cause scarring. Third degree burn. This burn reaches to the fat layer beneath the skin. Burned areas may be black, brown or white. The skin may look leathery. Third degree burns can destroy nerves, causing numbness. Hair follicles and sweat glands are destroyed. Assessment of burns. Various methods are used to estimate the total body surface area, TBSA, affected by burns. They are rule of nines, the Wallace method, Lund and Browder method, Palm method. Commonly we are using the rule of nines, Wallace method. Rule of nines. The rule of nines is quick way to estimate the extent of burns. The system assigns percentages in multiples of 9 to major body surfaces. Lund and Browder method. A more precise method of estimating the extent of a burn is the Lund and Browder method, which recognizes that the percentage of surface area of various anatomic parts, especially the head and legs, changes with growth. First aid. The basic first aid of burns we can say by triple C's, means cool, cover and cold. Cool means cool the burn area with running water. Cover means cover the burn area. Call means call emergency assistant. Place the burning patient in a horizontal position and roll him over in a blanket. In case of respiratory arrest, do positive breathing using mouth-to-mouth or mouth-to-mask technique. All clothing and jewelry should be removed. Cover the wound to minimize contamination. A clean technique should be maintained. Some don'ts in burns. Home remedies or medications should not be applied. Don't apply ice, don't apply toothpaste, Don't apply home remedies such as oil, egg or butter. And don't burst blisters. Minor burns, less than 10% can be treated in the hospital on an outpatient basis. Moderate and severe burns must be hospitalized for treatment, and adult clients or patients sustaining more than 20% burn require intravenous therapy. Management of burn injury. We can take it as three-phase management: emergent or resuscitative management, acute or intermediate management, and rehabilitation. Emergent care. It is important to remember the ABCs of all trauma care during the early post-burn period. Cool the wound, establish an airway. After wound cleaning, estimate percentage and depth of burn in a chart. Administer analgesics as per order for pain relief. An indwelling urinary catheter should be inserted. Insert large bore IV line for IV fluid infusion. 20% to 25% total body surface area burns. Nasogastric tube should be inserted. Dressing: open method and closed occlusive pressure dressing. Burn wound care: face and perineum should be exposed. Hands, polythene bag. Rest of the body, closed method should be used. Acute or intermediate phase begins 48 to 72 hours after the burn injury. Infection prevention, wound cleaning, topical antibacterial therapy, wound dressing, wound grafting, pain management, and nutritional support should be given. Rehabilitation phase. Our major goal is to prevent hypertrophic scarring. Complications of burn injury. Complications of deep or widespread burns can include bacterial infection, which may lead to sepsis. Fluid loss leads to hypovolemia, hypothermia, breathing problems from the intake of hot air or smoke. Keloids means scars or ridge areas caused by an overgrowth of scar tissue, and bone and joint problems such as contractures. Prevention of burns. A health talk to public. To reduce the risk of common household burns, never leave items cooking on the stove unattended. Don't carry or hold a child while cooking at the stove. Keep hot liquids out of the reach of children and pets. Keep electrical appliances away from water. Check the temperature of food before serving it to your child. Don't heat a baby's bottle in the microwave. If a small child is present, block his or her access to heat sources such as stoves, fireplaces and heaters. Unplug irons and similar devices when not in use. Cover unused electrical outlets with safety caps. Never smoke in bed. Keep a fire extinguisher on every floor of housing apartments. When using chemicals, always wear protective eyewear and clothing. Keep chemicals, lighters and matches out of the reach of children. Test bath water before placing a child in it. Thank you for watching. Hope you all like this video. For more videos, please subscribe to my channel, Nurse's Zone. Take care.